Hi guys, this is Griffin with the Command Valley Podcast, coming at you again with another fabulous deck tech. This one has been a deck of mine that I actually took apart because it was so fun for me and no fun for everybody else. But I am going to share the deck tech with you today. The deck tech will be for Mariki Riveri. Honestly, you could say I'm saying that wrong. I don't think anybody really knows how to say her name. But she is Esper, so black, blue, white for a 1/1 legendary creature human. Mariki doesn't untap during your untap step. However, you can tap her to gain control of target creature as long as you control Mariki. When Mariki leaves play or becomes untapped, destroy that creature. It can't be regenerated. So let me go ahead. We just did an episode on the 6-fold path of building a commander deck to really portray the idea. I'm gonna go ahead and go through that 6-path with you guys for this deck tech. The first on the path is, who's the commander? Mariki was the commander, and the reason why I picked her is because I wanted to build a commander for my favorite colors, which is Esper. One that was able to convey my desire for control. When I used to play Standard, one of my favorite decks to play was Esper Control, because I liked stopping other people from doing what they wanted to do while continuing my game plan. But not like a normal deck would do it, but very severely. So Mariki, the strategy with Mariki, which is the second part of the sixfold path, is what's the strategy? Her strategy is to basically attain complete control, but not control of everything, just control of what's the best. So Mariki is going to be able to tap to steal your opponent's best creature, whether it be an Azusa or whether it be a Baral that's also in this deck, but a Baral, whether it be those little utility creatures, because Mariki can come out early, or in the later game, the big creatures that make somebody else stand on top of the game. Now, obviously with Mariki, as you can see, you can only steal one thing at a time. If you want to try to steal another thing, you'll have to sacrifice that creature. That's okay. At this point in the game, when we're untapping Mariki, we're just getting rid of creatures because we're going to have plenty of extra time to untap Mariki with the shenanigans we're going to be pulling off. Now for the third step in the sixfold path of commander is, how are we going to get that strategy? How are we going to be able to attain this full control that us Esper players are so desperately trying to attain at all times? There's a couple of ways of doing this. The first thing I wanted to point out is that it's true that this deck relies heavily on Mariki because she's going to be able to take people's creatures, but that's not the only way that we're going to be able to attain control. So the first strategy in this deck is to untap Mariki, because obviously on her claws, she doesn't untap during your untap step. Now, obviously we're not worried about that because we can get around it. A couple of things that are gonna help us untap Mariki. The first thing is creatures. So a couple of these creatures are creatures like Stonybrook Angler, Nimbus of the Breath, Puppeteer, Vizier of Tumbling Sand. These are four creatures that allow you to untap Mariki. And if you have two of these out, you can do it on the same turn and steal people's creatures and kill them and steal another one, and really attain complete control really early in the game. A couple of artifacts that also do the same thing as those creatures are Puppet Strings, Unbender Tine, and Jandor's Saddlebags. So those are going to be the ways that we can untap Mariki to be able to tap her to steal people's creatures and essentially stay on top of the game by taking the best creatures from other people and keeping them for ourselves if we need them. The next strategy in this deck, because obviously we don't want to trust entirely on Mariki, we do have other ways of being able to attain control. So this section is going to be cards that are going to be able to steal other people's things without having Mariki needing to tap and untap. A couple of these cards are cards like Thief of Sanity, which allows you to hit people and steal one of their top three cards. Aura Thief, which allows you to just gain control of all enchantments when it leaves play. Gonti, Lord of Luxury, which is like Thief of Sanity. Hostage Staker, that can take a creature or an artifact. Willbreaker, that whenever that you use an ability on a creature that targets another creature that you don't control, you just gain control of that creature for as long as you control Willbreaker, which can get really nuts with some other cards that we have in here. The last thing I wanted to add in here is just spells that we can use to attain things that aren't just creatures, because as you probably guessed by this point, all of the creatures and artifacts and spells that I've talked about so far only attain creatures slash artifacts and other things. But now we're going to talk about spells that can attain anything that we want. So a couple of spells that we can use to steal things that aren't just creatures are spells like Acquire, which allows us to search in a library of our opponents for any artifact and put it into our play. Desertion, which is a counter spell, and if it's an artifact or creature, we can put it into play under our control. Dream Leash, which is an enchantment that just steals any permanent. And these are a couple of ways of just being able to take things that maybe Mariki can't get to. The last section that I wanted to talk about with Mariki is control what you can't take. The reason that I put this in here is when building Mariki, I knew that I wasn't going to be able to take control of everything. And I wasn't worried about that because Mariki can do a good job of taking the important things on her own. But I did want to include things in here that could just get rid of annoying pieces on the board that I cannot deal with. So some of these spells are things like Oblivion Ring, Detention Sphere, Quarantine Field, which are enchantments that can get rid of pesky creatures, artifacts, enchantments, you name it. We can just really clear the board of the things that are halting us. But there's also ways of being able to reset the board when it gets too far. I found with Mariki, there are some games where I cannot steal as much as is coming into play. But if I can reset the board and start off first, then I'm in a really good position. And some spells are spells like Terminus, Hour of Revelation, Urza's Ruinous Blast, and Fortunate Few. These are a few of the Esper-esque board wipes that can set us to be able to start off as the player in control. The next part that I wanted to talk about is the next step on the sixfold path of building a commander deck is how do I protect my strategy? Now, obviously with Mariki, it's an Esper control deck, so we have a lot of ways of being able to control and protect ourselves by either stealing creatures, stealing pesky enchantments, or getting rid of things that we don't like. But obviously we have included things like counter spells. That is Esper's best way of being able to deal with things that we can't handle. I'm not gonna talk about all the counter spells I have in here because a lot of them are pretty self-explanatory, but I am gonna go through the ones that I feel are also very important to the strength of the deck. So one of the first ones is this card called Insidious Will that says choose one counter target spell, or you may choose new targets for target spell, or copy target instant or sorcery spell. You may choose new targets for the copy. Now this is a really cool counter spell because you can essentially choose whether you want to counter, redirect, or make a copy of that spell, which can come real in handy in a lot of sticky situations that you may find yourself in that's apart from the normal counter target spell. Another one that is very important is a card called Summary Dismissal. It's an instant for 2 blue-blue that says exile all other spells and counter all abilities. This card is very much handy when the stack is so large and there are so many things that are going on, whether it be triggers off of a Dictate of Erebos that is really halting your game plan, whether it be triggers off of Thousand Year Storm. By casting Summary Dismissal and countering all spells and abilities on the stack, it can give you so much value to propel you into a better state than everybody else. The last one I wanted to talk about is Spell Swindle, which is a instant 3 blue-blue, which reads counter target spell, and then you create X treasures where X is that spell's converted mana cost. The reason why I've included this card is because one of the best ways to propel yourself forward in a game of Commander is by having more mana open than other people to be able to cast your spells. And Spell Swindle is an excellent way of both countering something that you can't control, countering some big threat, some big creature, and obtaining a ton of value by getting all of these treasures to help you cast your other spells. Now, of course, we have all the normal counter spells like Counterspell, Arcane Denial, Mana Leak, Disallow, Hinder, Sinister Sabotage. Included all of them. You can check out the deck list for the full list of them. Now, the fifth step on the building a commander deck is how are you going to halt other people's game plans? We've kind of gone through that with how to protect ourselves. An Esper deck, really the strategy to control covers both protection and stopping other people's strategies. So we're going to counter spells that may help somebody win the game. We're going to steal creatures that are helping people win the game. We're going to
take total control
over the board and halt any other strategy that could overrun you. So by using the enchantments, by using Mariki, by using spells that are taking control of other people's permanents, artifacts, creatures, we're stopping their game plan as well as protecting our own. So these two steps can get jumbled into one. However, all of the cards that help you to protect yourself are also going to help you to stop other people's strategies. The last thing I wanted to talk about is a few cards that didn't fit into any one of these categories that just have been very useful in the deck that I have made. The first one is Royal Elemental, which is 3 blue-blue-blue for a flying elemental 3/2 with landfall. Whenever a land enters the battlefield under your control, you may gain control of target creature for as long as you control Royal Elemental. This is a exceptionally unique card to be able to do what Mariki does, except you just gain control of them and you don't have to tap or untap. This card will give you so much utility in the late game when you're unable to cast Mariki because she's been removed too many times and you can just keep the ball rolling on taking people's creatures. The next one I want to talk about is Angel of Serenity, an excellent budget control card for 4 white. Angel of Serenity is a 5/6 flying creature angel When Angel of Serenity enters the battlefield, you may exile up to 3 target creatures from the battlefield and or creature cards from graveyards. When Angel of Serenity leaves the battlefield, return the exiled cards to their owner's hands. This card has been a lifesaver in many of my games in any deck that I play it, simply because when you exile these cards under Angel of Serenity, people assume that if they kill Angel of Serenity, it goes back onto the battlefield, but that's not true. It goes back into their hand, which that in itself is exceptionally unique in this control deck. The last card I want to talk about is the all-star card in this deck that I will talk about that goes super well with Willbender, and it is Tidal Force. It is 5 blue, blue, blue for a 7/7 elemental. At the beginning of each upkeep, you may tap or untap target permanent. Now, this could be used in a couple of ways. You can untap your lands, you can tap other people's lands, you can untap Mariki, you can tap Mariki. But with Willbender, whenever you untap or tap or target by using that untap or tap ability with Tidal Force and Willbender out, you are gaining control of each creature at every upkeep. It is an exceptionally controlling, hard to deal with combo that doesn't necessarily let you win the game, but it is a really good way of being able to propel you into that winning state. Now, the last thing I want to talk about in our sixfold path of Commander is Reflection. Now, when I played this deck, the first reflection that I made, and I really want to let you guys know this, is that Mariki, in the way that I have built it, is very, very controlling. It is not fun to play against. It's very fun to play with, but it's not fun to play against. So I wouldn't advise using this deck consistently as your main. But I do definitely recommend building this deck. It's very fun to build and bring to your Friday Night Magic and be able to just show the power of the Esper colors and how total control can be achieved. Another thing that I wanted to talk about with Reflection is just how the deck plays. Mariki, the strategy with Mariki is to be able to get her out as early as possible and start using her as early as possible. You may think that you want to save Mariki for the later game to steal the big creatures, but what's really important is to use Mariki to steal the utility creatures that are coming out to be able to assist you in getting to that late game where you already have spells that you're going to be able to cast to take control of the board. Alright guys, with that is the end of the deck tech. I hope you guys enjoyed. For a full deck list, please look at the show notes for the link to full deck list. With that, honestly guys, this is a very flexible deck. A lot of these cards are swapped in and out. There's a lot of cards that you can add and take out. Just have a lot of fun building your own variation of what you want out of an Esper control deck. Just have a lot of fun with this. And remember to please check out our other content. We release deck techs every Monday. And please also check out our podcast version called Late Night Drive. This name will probably be changing, but this is our podcast where we sit down and talk about topics in Magic that will interest you. Please go check that out. With that is all I have for you guys tonight. Have a great one. We'll see you next time.